guys, my name is JessiMew, and welcome back to the Tribe of the Tides, where in the last episode, Koreme was miraculously cured of her illness after this little baby right down here, the savior, managed to find a healing fruit off in the grass. He literally stumbled upon this thing just out of sheer luck, and now all of the damage that Koreme took over her life while she was sick was completely removed, so she has 9 days left on her lifespan, and that means that she's going to be able to get to know this baby that she's carrying too, and for that matter, she might even be able to have another baby with Dewdrop. They kind of took off from the water pack. They took off through the grass, they didn't leave any sort of trail behind them so that nobody would be able to find them, and I feel like at this point, Jasper and Ilaire must be so frazzled. I mean, not only do they have so much rustling grass around them at all times, but all of these strange critters are just like popping out of the grass from all different locations. We have Taronu, who oddly enough is actually a full sibling of Ilaire, but because she left so early, I feel like they probably don't remember each other. They might get suspicious because they both have the same color gems, so they might think that maybe they came from the same part of the island, but otherwise, they are basically meeting each other for the very first time here. Though Taronu is not a bad little critter to have around himself with his two double claws, he is very, very focused, because he did chase bunnies from all the way over where the carnivores live to their particular part of the island, but I feel like he is a very good individual to have around just because he's so strong. Now, of course, a lot of things took place on the water side of the tribe as well, our little water babies. We have Echo here now, who spent the last couple of days with his mother, actually, who unfortunately passed while they were fishing, but now he has been left with this broken family. He had two children with Koreme himself, Marina and Cove, and I feel like they are probably very, very confused right now. I'm sure Echo doesn't really think that she would just pack up and leave them, so he might actually believe that she passed away somewhere, passed away in the grass because of her illness. And I feel like that's probably what he's telling his children right now, even though he hopes maybe he can find her again. He might sniff around for a while and try to see if he can find her, but for the most part, he is very, very sad right now along with their two children, so he might have to pass along his duties to someone else in the pack because he's not going to be doing much leading right now. We do have this little baby though. This little baby was also born in the last episode, who is the ultimate collector. He has two berry paws, he has the cracker jaw, so he can do a lot of collecting for this side of the pack. And a lot of you guys mentioned that maybe we should keep his name as Vankir, so he might ascend to become the god of the harvest in our own personal lore, just like Animame is kind of like the goddess of war. So Vankir is going to keep his name, but I do have all of those names that you guys left for me, and I wrote them down, and I'm hoping that we can use them in his personal family if he ends up having children, though honestly, he is probably going to have a lot of children. And in fact, what I'm thinking he might do once he has a second gem and he's safe from the bird. I mean, the bird isn't in our skies right now, but we don't want to risk it because he is very important, so he's going to be well guarded. He's probably going to start scooting along the shore to find some shells because he is one of the few who could definitely collect them, so maybe he'll take like a little guard with him and they'll go all around these tide pools and try to find some food for the pack. I mean, we have plenty of shells around here that most of our creatures can't actually pick up, especially not the carnivores. They are not interested in the shells. They're basically only interested in these little bunny burrows. Cece was coming over here to check out the bunny burrow, in fact, but I think she's probably going to scoot around it, not only to light up the area over here, but also to sniff around this place where the traditional is just packed up and left, because she is feeling a little bit neglected right now, I think. A lot of you mentioned that she looks exactly like her brother, Nuku, who took over the throne, and even though she was the firstborn, she wasn't allowed to take on the role of queen of the island. So Duke Meme, I feel like he was just really full of himself, and he also kind of abandoned the old ways of the pack. So despite the fact that he was only allowed to become king because of his likeness to Animeme, I feel like he probably kind of abandoned that too. So that's why he chose Nuku over Cease, though he also has those perfect genetics too, so there is a possibility that she was just a little bit weaker growing up than her brother was. She does have that one gene of hemophilia, so maybe she tires out a little bit more, and he just figured that this little baby who kind of ascended to the throne when he still just had a couple of gems would do a better job leading than she was. would, though she is definitely feeling very, very neglected right now. So she's actually going to sit on top of this little log right here for now to not only light up the area, like I said, but also to just kind of sniff around the things that all of the traditionalists left behind, because they moved way over here, and they also have a brand new addition, because while Komeko was trying to find a place for them to settle down, she ran into Bolt. Now, this is going to be interesting, because Eclipse is one of the very last creatures who was around for the old island, the starter island, so he does remember Crystal and Quartz, and I feel like he might be a little bit suspicious seeing this random crackerjaw baby sitting in the nest right now. I do feel like she would probably name him Cloud, too, just as kind of like a very, very quiet nod toward Bolt himself. I'm wondering if maybe Birch knows too. Maybe Birch knows where this baby actually came from, but he's not going to say anything. He's being very, very loyal as they try to clear out this area. And I think we have a bunny right here. I'm pretty sure there's a bunny trying to steal our berries, so hopefully we can skip the turn pretty soon so that it doesn't eat up all of the food that we have over there, because the traditionalists will definitely prefer to eat their berries. Now, I'm hoping that Nuku and Summer can start a family in this episode too, and I'm thinking that we could possibly place the big ears in the mutation menu for them, because it would be nice if maybe they could grow those big ears and start them looking like little bunnies themselves. It might help lure the bunnies out from their burrows too if we can pull that off. So hopefully that'll be taking place in this episode. Summer is still munching away at her berries, in fact. She's still, like, sneaking little berries off of these berry bushes, even though they're technically supposed to be using them as a bait. Just like this one. I think that's probably a bunny, too. Can Nuku actually scoot around to him check? We do have a bunny burrow right here, so that is probably why there's something rustling. Let's have him sit in the grass. Yeah, there we go. There's the bunny. So you can save that turn for now, just in case it comes back. And let's actually have Kirtavan go over here to light up the nest, because we are going to need that very, very shortly. And are our berries disappearing? It actually doesn't look like it. That's kind of surprising. I am going to have to check that out then. Unfortunately, all of these creatures are out of turns, so they can't do that right now, but we are definitely going to have to check that out soon. So Vankir, why don't we place you right next to Wave so that you are protected, very, very well protected, and that you're right next to one of these berry bushes too, so he'll be able to start collecting from that very shortly. His father, Kanuvan, is going to have to scoop up these berries on his very last turn, though thankfully he did complete his mission. He gave us a very, very good nimble-fingered baby, so I'm sure he's quite happy with his son. He'll go ahead and peek in this grass too, and it looks like we have more crabbits crawling up the shore, so we'll have to keep an eye on those. They can get out of hand very quickly. In fact, Misty might come down here to try to take care of it, and maybe she'll call Cove or Marina over too, just to kind of take their minds off of all of the drama going down on the side of the pack right now. So Cove is going to scoot down here and slap this little crabbit for us. There we go, and Misty can do the same. And there we go, that actually took them out. Okay, so we'll gather up the crabbit meat. Very good, you two. You're a little crabbit hunting duo today, I guess. Marina is going to stay right next to her father for now, just to keep him company, because I'm sure she is very, very worried about him too. And I guess Wave could go ahead and pick a couple of these berries just to kind of show Vankir how it's done, but honestly, it probably comes naturally to him with all of his nimble fingers. Now, let's see, we have Isla back here with Cinder too, who I'm hoping are going to be able to start their own adorable little family. And we are going to have to get to work on that very soon. I mean, they have been very quiet over here. It has been a very, very quiet relationship, but eventually I want them to have at least one child together because I feel like they would be absolutely adorable. So let's go ahead and pick some berries with them, and then Isla can go ahead and expand the territory a little bit, because I'm hoping pretty soon we'll be able to do some fishing down here. There we go. These orange fish actually give us quite a bit of food, so that's really what I'm after. Right now we have Pearl back here with the fishing tail, so she's kind of the only one who could catch them on her own. And I guess for now she can go ahead and peek in some of this grass for us, just to clear out the area a little bit more. That is going to be the focus on this side of the pack today, just because there's so much grass in here and they really need to expand and make sure that the territory is safe. Now Riptide, you have the crackerjaw too, so you can pick up these acorns. There is something rustling right here though, which I'm assuming again is probably another bunny, but if we could have River jump over here to check. Okay, it's probably like right in here then. Let's go ahead and have Riptide knock down some more acorns and just check and see. Yeah, that bunny is not coming back out, so let's have her move over here instead. There we go. The bunny hopped right down to the shore, so hopefully in the next turn she could jump on it and grab it up for us. Now it looks like Nuku still hasn't found his bunny, so let's move him back over here so that he's closer to his mate. And then I think we might be done with this turn now. So let's go ahead and skip. And yeah, like, this bunny, if this is a bunny, it hasn't picked up any of these berries. So that is very, very strange. And I think I am definitely going to keep an eye on that when we pass the day. But I think that's about it. So let's go ahead and pass the day now. Nobody's giving birth at the moment. And our poor nimble-fingered father back there unfortunately passed away. So let's see what is rustling over here, because that is kind of top priority right now. Let's have Birch jump in here for us. Oh my goodness. Are you a new pack member? Wait a second, you are! Oh my gosh, look at her! She has the water body too! And she has the beak in her recessives! Okay, that is quite interesting. So Anara, we definitely want to accept you into the pack. Let's go ahead and invite her so that she can join us. And oh my goodness, she was sitting right next to a nest. How adorable is that? Maybe she was actually born here? Maybe this is where her family settled down before? Oh my gosh, that is adorable. And she's like the only one left, unfortunately. So she was just kind of like watching from the grasses as all of these strange creatures encroached upon her previous home. That's quite interesting. Now let's have Eclipse pick a couple of these berries, and then he can scoot up here to say hello to Komeko, and also to meet this little baby, which again, I'm sure he is very, very suspicious of. But honestly, he is so old at this point. He only has 2 days left on his lifespan that maybe they wouldn't really worry about the ramblings of an old man. I do wonder if maybe she's telling him that it was from a wandering male, though. I feel like that's the only thing that could really save her right now. She's probably just telling the entire pack that she ran into a wandering male on her way here and Birch was just too far away to help her. But let's have Honey scoot her way up here too. She can go ahead and pick up the crabbit meat, of course, and then the rest of the berries for us. So she's probably going to settle down right next to this berry bush, and her father can go ahead and clear out the area a little bit more. We can now have Birch come over here, in fact, and clear out the area on the right side of the pack. Though we're going to have to watch out for these leeches too, because those can be very, very deadly, as we know. Now it looks like you can take on your final gem, and we should probably have you two start breeding very soon. Summer only has 10 days left of her life. She's actually quite a bit older than Nuku is. So let's go ahead and have them breed. And then she can sit right in the nest right now and we can set up their mutation menu. So for them, I would like to place the big ears in the 30% slot just to see if maybe we can have a little bunny baby born on the side of the island. And Cease. Let's see, maybe you would start following in the footsteps of the traditionalist pack. Maybe she would kind of wander this way along the same path that the other tribe took. She might go ahead and try to snag this crabbit on the way though. Unfortunately, it hasn't passed away yet, but she can whittle it down. Maybe Kirtavan will help her out too, because they would probably enjoy the crabbit meat at the very least. And it looks like River can take on her final gem too. You're also all grown up. You were going after a bunny, I believe, right? Unfortunately, it looks like the bunny has disappeared. Let's have her come down here to see if she can find any more. She could scoot along the shore. There it is! You chased it right into Misty! So she can go ahead and snag up the bunny for us. There we go. And then Echo and Marina, of course. I feel like, oh my gosh, wait a second, Echo is sick? Oh, that is so sad. He is so sad, so heartbroken over Koreme that he actually got himself sick too with the common cold. Oh my gosh, Marina must be completely worried about her father right now. Why don't they actually go along this way toward the place where he spent his mother's final days with her? They can kind of scoot along to this little stream right here and spend some quality time together. In fact, maybe he'll sink himself right into the waters. Unfortunately, she won't be able to follow him because she doesn't have the water body, though she does have it in her genetics, so if she has a baby, there is a chance that we could pull it out again. And then we have Wave, of course, with Vankeer. Why don't we actually have Wave come over here to pick up the crabbit meat for us? And then Vankeer, you can pick your very first berries. There we go, no troubles at all. Why don't we actually have Wave scoot over this way too, so that Vankeer can hopefully set up between these two berry bushes on the next turn once he has a little bit more energy. I think he might actually be getting his second gem on the next turn too. So that would be excellent if we could start moving him away from his packmates just to pick up from all of these berry bushes, because goodness knows we could definitely use more hands at the berry bushes. So Riptide, why don't you sit over here so that you can pick up more of these acorns in one swipe? And then I think we're also going to have Isla breed with Cinder right now, because they are getting older. So we'll go ahead and do that, and then Isla can come over here and help by picking up a couple of these berries at least. It's not going to be much, but they can pick up a couple at a time. And then maybe Cinder could move this way instead to clear out the area a little bit more. I feel like he is not going to let anyone explore this area beyond this little rock right here, this little border of their territory, because he doesn't want anyone to find his sister. He just wants her to be happy, honestly. Like, he's not sure if she's still alive out there because she was very, very sick, but he wants her to be happy. So River can scoot up this way so that she can hopefully pick from this little shriveled up berry bush on the next turn. And then I think that's this part of the island complete. So let's move back here and make sure that nothing is out of the ordinary. It looks like everyone's doing okay. So Koreme, you can officially sit down in this nest and have your very first baby. Oh my gosh, I am so happy for her too. And she's also protecting Diamond, who is probably going to be sticking very, very close to her. I mean, he is the savior. He is our little savior of this part of the island. Now, Dewdrop, what is rustling back here? Oh my gosh, really? Really? There is another healing fruit in this area? Like, this part of the pack is so well off right now. This is amazing. So let's go ahead and peek at this too so that we can definitely use that in the future. I don't think anyone particularly needs it right now, but that is going to be excellent for us. We have two healing fruits accessible right now. We are going to have to wait for this one to grow back anyway, so hopefully we can keep that on hand for as long as possible. Let's have a pearl peek in the grass around this little stump right here, and then we can have Jasper pick up this meat. Unfortunately, Jasper is going to be passing away in 2 days, so it seems like they won't be having any more children together. Ilair is going to live quite a bit longer because she was quite a bit younger, so we'll have her pick up those berries, we'll have him clear out a little bit more of this grass to keep his family safe, and then we can have Taronu actually scoot off of this way too to figure out what all of this rustling is. Though honestly, I feel like it's probably just bunnies. Koreme, you can at least peek at this cactus, but please do not use it because we don't want you getting hurt again. And then I think that is it. So we are officially going to see the very first baby of Koreme and Dewdrop now. Oh my gosh, I am sure that they're going to be the most adorable little panda babies. Of course. I mean, their genetics do look kind of similar anyway, though Dewdrop has the gills in his recessives and Koreme actually has the cracker jaw in hers, so there is a possibility that some crazy, crazy mutation could take place. But let's go ahead and skip the day and see what their first baby looks like. Oh my gosh, the cracker jaw! It actually happened, the cracker jaw! That is adorable, Nuvon! Oh my gosh. He does have his father's no paw, but look at that. He also carried the gills in his recessives too, so again, we have the possibility of taking that out of their genetics at some point. He has those gorgeous black horns too though, oh my gosh, I was not expecting that. That is really cool. Okay, so I'm actually going to wait to name their children until they have all of the children that they're going to have so that we can name them all at once. So if we could have somebody protect this baby, I guess Ilair. Ilair could come over here just in case some two gems isn't enough to protect them. We will change Diamond's gem over. This means that he can at least explore the area a little bit more for us. I mean, he is a very, very good explorer if he manages to stumble upon this healing fruit. But just in case he can't protect this baby from the bird, we'll have his mother sit there instead, and she can go ahead and peek in the grass too for that matter. And then we could have Koreme come over here to breed with Dewdrop yet again, and then they can have another little baby together. Oh my gosh, this would not have been possible if not for that healing fruit, so I am very, very happy. Now let's have her pick this little berry for us, and then Dewdrop, why don't you scoot over this way toward the water side? I would like him to peek in some of this grass over here. He's kind of going to escort Pearl, in fact, to the water side so that they can hopefully find some fish together. Since he was from the water side of the island, he would probably be a good candidate to mentor her in the ways of fishing. Unfortunately, Ilair and Jasper don't know anything about fishing, so she will probably scoot along this way, and then we can have Jasper sit on top of the little stump for now. I mean, he's going to pass away on the next turn, so this is kind of like his last chance to benefit the pack. And we did unlock a new gene over here. Oh, the beak. Okay, the beak. Wait a second. Does that mean that we have the beak on one of our babies? Hold on a second here. This baby! Are you kidding me? This baby right here? We were trying to get some bunnies on this side of the island, but instead we have a little platypus. Oh my gosh, look at him! This is our very first experience with the beak too. Oh my goodness, what on earth are we going to do with you? Like, that completely throws a wrench in my plans, in all honesty, but oh my goodness, let's look at his model too. Let's see if I can find him. Is this him? Yes, it is. Look at that gorgeous beak. Oh my gosh. He is so interesting looking too, with the stripes and everything, and he has the webbed feet, so he should be able to move a little bit faster in the water too. That is really something, though. We are going to have to figure out exactly where he falls in the rankings of this pack in particular. Now, I do see a bunny back there for Nuku. Let's see if you can pounce on him. Oh my gosh, a ton of bunnies! There we go. So our little trap is definitely working, which is good to see. But let's see, Summer, why don't you scoot over here and just munch on a couple of your berries yet again. You are still stealing our berries. And I guess in the next turn we'll have them breed again. But for now, let's see. I think Kirtavan will probably come down here to help Cease out just to collect this crabbit meat. There we go. He could actually scoop it up right with his last turn. And then Cease can continue her journey following in the footsteps of the traditionalist pack down the shore. And scouting out all of these shells too that unfortunately she can't do anything with. Oh my goodness, and I love her too. Inara, you are absolutely perfect. We have immunity gene F and G on her too, so let's just take a quick peek around here. Cloud has H and B. That's interesting. So they could possibly be a good pairing. And then Birch has I and H. Okay, that could be good too. And he's actually fully grown, so maybe we should have them have a baby too. She does have the blindness in her recessive, so we'll have to keep an eye on that as well, of course. Of course, and she does have the no paw too, so we don't want that running rampant around this pack. Unfortunately, Cloud does have a no paw as well, so actually that would probably not be a good pairing, would it? Because we don't want the double no paws popping up again like Splash the first. So instead, we'll have Honey go ahead and pick up the berries. She could actually move down here to pick up the shell too. There we go. And then let's have Inara and Birch have a baby. So we'll have him come over here since she's a little bit slower with her webbed hind feet. And hopefully they can pass the water body along too. I mean, it's going to be a little bit strange because of course Adam and Eve did not have the water body. So I'm not sure if this pack would really be interested in scavenging the waters. But maybe with all of the clamshells that Honey is picking up lately, they're a little bit more interested in what could possibly be waiting for them off in the ocean. So we'll have Birch breed with her and then she could sit straight on the nest and peek in a little bit of the grass to keep the area safe. And then Eclipse, on his very final day, he could scoot over this way to not only get a closer look at this baby here, this little baby Cloud, but also to clear out the area on this side of the island. So Cloud, why don't you actually scoot next to your mother? And then she can come over here and also clear out the way. It would be nice if we could make our way over to this tree as well, so that Cloud will have a little job to do. He could crack open all of the acorns over here. And that is actually very, very close to this pack too, I just noticed. If they clear out all of this grass, then they'll be able to wave to each other from across this little pond right here. That's going to be interesting. I wonder if they're going to have to fight over all of these fish in here, especially now that we have someone with a water body too. But we'll leave Birch right there and actually venture over to this side of the island. So how are you guys doing? It looks like Marina is fully grown. Oh my gosh, she's so beautiful too, isn't she? She's almost again a spinning image of her mother, so another reason that Echo is probably feeling very, very sad right now. Oh my gosh, and he only has 6 days left on his life too. That is really sad. I guess we'll have him scoot up this way to peek in a little bit more of this grass, and then Marina can follow him. They can go over to the berry bush and maybe collect a couple of berries for the pack. They can pick their berries together. I mean, unfortunately, they're not the best at fishing because they don't have the fishing tail, so they're not really looking for fish at the moment. But we'll have Cove come over here and continue clearing out the grass. We don't want him, of course, to accidentally move to a different island, so we're going to be very careful about that. But at least they'll be able to clear it out, and maybe there'll be some hidden resources over there. And then Misty. Misty, why don't we actually have you come toward the mainland a little bit more? You could sit between these nests. Actually, the nests are empty right now, so it might be a good time for Isla to come down there and have her baby. But first, let's see what's in the grass right here. A bunny. A bunny trying to steal our berries. So while Cinder protects the berry bush, we'll have Isla make her way over to the nests. I think she can actually get there in one turn, can't she? Yeah, she can. Excellent. Okay, so she's going to have her baby on the next turn. The bunny seems to have disappeared, unfortunately. And then we can have River pick up the shriveled up berries right here. Oh my goodness. Okay, there you are. You kind of circled around me, didn't you? Let's have him pounce on the bunny and grab up the meat as fast as he can. And then he can collect that on the next turn. And Riptide, you can gather up the acorns instead. And maybe we could have him sit over here so he can pick a couple of those berries too. I mean, unfortunately, Vankir can only do so much. So we'll have him sit in between these berry bushes for now just to pick up a couple more berries. Thankfully, he has a second gem now, so he is safe from the bird. Though once again, we have not seen the bird in quite a while, so I'm a little bit surprised. Hopefully pretty soon he'll also be able to start making his journey down the shore, and I think Wave might actually stick with him. I feel like he's going to be a very dedicated guard. Not only is he his brother, but he would be a very, very dedicated guard to the god of the harvest. So for now, Wave, come over here and pick a couple of the berries for your brother, and then I think we might actually be done with this turn. So I just want to make sure that our mutation menu is set up correctly. We do have a couple of turns that we could do back here though. Let's see. Pearl, you could peek in this grass for us. We could have Taronu kind of expand this way. Oh, there we go. Another one of those berry bushes. So we'll peek at that. We'll peek at the rock too so that we know it's there. And then Jasper can stay right on top of that stump for his very last turn. So we have Anara and we have Isla giving birth. So I think what I'll do is I'll swap this around so that the water body is in the 30% slot, just because it would be important for either of these families to have the water body at this point. And then let's see, maybe we want to stick with the normal blood clotting because it looks like a few of these guys do have hemophilia. Oh, for that matter, Birch has like complete hemophilia, so that would be a good idea to keep that in the mutation menu for us. Now let's see, I guess first we'll go ahead and look at Isla's baby because I'm quite curious to see what this one's going to look like. Let's see, I have a feeling, oh my goodness, that he is going to be adorable, and he absolutely is. Oh, look at this guy. He doesn't have the water body, but he does have the gills, so he can definitely do quite a bit of swimming. And the antlers that his father had too. Let's see if we can find his little model down here somewhere. I believe his name is Roku. Yes, it is. Oh my gosh. Look how majestic he is. He is absolutely gorgeous. Okay, so we definitely need to find a name for him too. And let's actually name him Shark. We'll name him Shark for his gills, and then let's go see the other baby too. Let's go all the way over to the other side of the island. We do need to snatch up that bunny back there as well, so hopefully I'll remember that. Oh my goodness, poor Eclipse too. Poor little Eclipse ended up passing away on that turn. So let's see, Tekir, you have the spiky body? Oh my goodness, that's interesting. I didn't realize that they had the spiky body in their genetics. So the spiky body passed over the water body, even though we had it in the mutation menu, so we didn't manage to get that random mutation on him. He does have the no paw too, which is a little bit unfortunate. Spiky body, oh my gosh. That is very, very interesting, and he has hemophilia to top it all off, so not exactly the luckiest baby over here, unfortunately, especially with that spit snout. But we haven't had a little porcupine in the pack in a very long time, have we? So I'm sure she will love her baby despite its flaws, I'm sure she will. And we'll have Birch go ahead and pick up the crabbit meat instead. And honey, you're going to have to come back over here and pick the berries for us. There we go. And then we'll have Birch come up here to peek in this grass. And there's those bunnies too. And I forgot about the bunny back here. Oh my goodness, I knew that was going to happen. So let's have Cease scoot along this way so that she can hopefully catch up to the bunny. In fact, that might be what she's doing at this point. Instead of just blindly following in the footsteps of this pack, she's chasing after this bunny over here who is zipping all around her. And now she's stumbled into the sight of Honey over here. So I don't think any of these guys can actually grab the rabbit. Anara is not fast enough, and I'm not sure if she actually has any strength on her. She actually doesn't. She can't attack, so she wouldn't be able to pick up the bunny anyway. And these guys are just a little bit too far away. So we'll have Komeko keep going this way with her baby. And in fact, does he have a second gem? Yeah, he does. So he is perfectly safe. We don't have to worry about protecting him. He can scoot over this way and help her by clearing out a little bit of the grass. And then we can go straight over to this tree over here and start clearing this out on the next turn too. We do have something rustling over here though. It's probably just the bunny that ran away from Nuku, I think. Oh my gosh, and we have a carnivore too. How did I not notice that? Oh, Pearl, did he hit you? It doesn't look like it. Okay, she did not hit you. So we'll give Pearl her very last gem, and luckily, because she has her double claws, she is definitely going to be able to help take care of this guy. So why don't we go ahead and slap him with all of your turns, and there we go. That's all that we actually needed. So not only is Pearl going to do a very good job fishing, but she also is a little beast, just like her father and her mother. Her father did pass away too on top of his stump, so we'll have to find somebody else to sit there instead. And in fact, maybe Diamond could come up here and use the stump for now. He might be a good one to do that because, of course, he is the savior of the pack, so he can sit on top of his own little makeshift throne, and then Dewdrop can come over here and pick up the meat for us, and he can light up the grass a little bit too, because we definitely need to do that. Now, why don't we move their first little baby out of the nest? We'll scoot him right here so that he's still protected by Ilair, and then Koreme can come over to the nest and use it on the next turn instead. So she has 6 days left of her life, and I think that means that they should be able to have a third baby too. So once she has her third baby, we'll go ahead and name all three of them together, and I think that will probably happen in the next episode. So Taronu, for now, why don't you peek in some of this grass? We'll have you clear out the area a little bit more for us just to keep us safe. And we could actually have Ilair come over here just to peek in this grass for us, since this baby is protected by his mother now. Okay, so Nuku, we want you to come back over here too to have another baby, because we have this build baby sitting inside the nest. Like, I feel like he is going to be very, very shocked when he gets back. He probably has no idea what's waiting for him over here. And there's another one of those bunnies. Okay, so Kirtavan, maybe you could actually trap it somehow. We'll have him sit right there. And we need Summer to stay next to the nest so she can't move. But we'll have Nuku come over here to breed with her again. There we go. And then we could actually move this little build baby right next to his father. And then we'll move Summer into the nest and swap around the mutation menu again, so that hopefully we can get some big ears on this baby instead of the beak. That is very, very shocking. I still can't believe that we managed to mutate the beak of all things on their family. So how much longer do you have on your life, Echo? 4 days. I mean, it's so sad because he's actually going to pass away before Koreme even. Koreme is going to outlive poor Echo. I mean, there's really no possibility that he could even scoot up here in time, I don't think, because there's so much grass for them to go through. But at least he can spend some of his final days with his daughter, because she is definitely sticking right by his side, just like he stuck by his mother's side before she passed away. So for now, I guess you guys can pick a couple more of these berries, two each, and then we'll have you start playing leapfrog off this way. Maybe they could come down to the beach, actually. Like, I see this bunny scooting along the shore, so they might be able to pick up some extra food. But until he passes away, we'll have them kind of just wander the shore together and enjoy their final days. Now, Cove, you are fully grown, which is definitely good to see, so you could clear out a little bit more of this grass over here. It doesn't seem like there's too many resources over here, but at least this makes it so we won't have to worry about carnivores spawning in the area. And I think it might also be time for Vankir to start making his journey down the shoreline as well. So we'll have a Wave and Vankir make their way this way. They'll go down the opposite shore of Echo and Marina. So if he goes over here, then hopefully he'll be able to pick up some shells in these tide pools. And in fact, we'll have a Wave kind of scoot over this way just to hopefully scout out the area, though it seems like all of the shells may have disappeared. So it's going to be a little bit longer before they can find anything worthwhile to eat. You know, maybe he could actually leave one baby behind him before he leaves. Vankir is going to be growing up in, I believe, about 2 days, so that is a possibility. He could have one baby over on this side of the island, and then he can scoot along the shore and see what else he can find in this big world. That might be what we do. We'll have to figure out who he could possibly breed with, just to leave the nimble fingers behind him. And of course, we're going to be seeing Koreme's next baby in the next episode too, and hopefully her final baby as well. I'm pretty sure she can have three, so once they have their trio of babies, we will officially name all of them and watch their family continue to grow. But for now, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye, guys!